In Unity's audio mixer, the send and receive effects give us a great deal of control over how our signals are routed through the mix, and particularly to effects. In this scene, we have four game objects, each with an audio source and an audio clip loaded that's a loop of a music track. In our mixer, we've set up two effect return tracks. These are normal groups, which have respectively a reverb on reverb return and an echo effect on echo return. Currently, they're not receiving signal from any of the other tracks in the mixer, but if we want to get a signal to them, we can do that using the send and receive effects. Let's start with our arpeggio sound, which sounds like this. What we're going to do is that we're going to use a send effect to split the signal so that our arpeggio will continue to be routed through the master output, but will also have a duplicate of its signal with a controllable volume sent, in this case, to the reverb return. So first, we're going to go to our reverb return track and we're going to set up our destination, our receive. We're going to choose add, receive. Now, it's important to note that the sequence of these effects in the channel strip is very important. In this case, the signal from the receive effect is coming into the chain after the reverb, meaning that its signal will not be processed by the reverb effect. What we're going to do is move the reverb down so it's in the chain after the receive. Now we're going to go to our arpeggio and we're going to apply a send effect. We're going to choose add, send. Now we'll see over in the inspector that we have a choice for what bus to route the send to. The term bus comes from the world of audio mixers, in which a bus can be used to route signal from one channel to another or to multiple other channels. In this case, the choice is between routing to a receive effect or to a duck volume effect. For more on duck volume effects, check out the information linked below. We're going to choose our reverb return receive effect. Now, we'll notice that a send level becomes visible. This is how much duplicated signal is being routed to the receive effect. We're going to start playing and turn that up so we can hear the effect happen. And you can hear when I stop it, we get that nice reverb tail tailing off there, because now the arpeggio sound has been routed through the receive effect, through the SFX reverb plugin, and that's creating that nice psychoacoustic impression of our sound being played in a large space. What reverb effects do is they simulate the reflections of sound bouncing off of surfaces and returning to the listener in an acoustic space. Our synthesizer sound never occurred in an acoustic space, so it has no natural reflections, and we're adding those using the reverb effect. It's worth noting, when we work with reverb effects via sends and receives, that the dry level should be turned all the way down so that we don't duplicate the unaffected signal. It's also worth noting that the order of the attenuation and the send in our group is important. Currently, the attenuation effect is before the send, meaning if we turn down volume using the attenuation effect, the signal will stop passing to the send. Let's give that a try. We can hear the trail trails off and the sound ends. If we reorder these effects, we'll get a different effect. We're going to place the attenuation after the send. And what you'll hear is that by placing the send before the attenuation effect, the send is not going to have its volume turned down. It will still receive volume before the attenuation turns the signal down. The result is that the send is going to continue sending signal out, even though the main channel is turned off. What we can hear in this case is that whether or not the volume is turned down, the send is still getting its volume out to the reverb return. And now what we're hearing is only the wet signal of the reverb coming back into the main mix via the reverb return. This can be interesting for some non-traditional effects, but typically you're going to prefer attenuation followed by your send. It's also worth noting, as I mentioned earlier, that if the receive effect is after, for example, the reverb in this case, we're going to receive no effect. So it's important for any effects that you want to process your signal to be placed in the chain after the receive effect. Now, one of the other major uses of sends is that we can use it to process multiple channels with the same effect. So in this track, we also have a percussion element. And what we can do by adding a send to that and routing that also to the reverb, we can add reverb, the same reverb, to both of our tracks. So we can hear, this gives us a very consistent psychoacoustic impression, which is especially important if we're aiming for realism, to have things passing into the same reverbs so that they feel like they're emanating in the same environment. It's also possible to use send and receive effects to route one signal to multiple effects. What we're going to do is we're going to send our arpeggio additionally to our echo effect on our echo return group. We're going to add a receive effect to the echo return and move it up in the chain so that its signal will pass through the echo. Then on the arpeggio, we're going to add a send and assign its output to the echo return receive. Once that's assigned, we can test. And you can hear with that nice tail that our arpeggio is now being passed to both the reverb return and the echo return groups that we've created here via the two receive effects. What's great about this setup is that we can control the levels individually using the send volumes, and we can really achieve a lot of flexibility in our mix this way. It's also worth noting that this is a common audio industry best practice, because processing audio signals, especially with reverb, can be very processor intense. Having a reverb on each of these tracks could have a serious CPU resource cost at runtime. So minimizing our use of effects by sending multiple effects to the same reverb on a return track is going to save us some CPU resources that we'll probably need elsewhere in our game.